Proprietary is a synonym to bad. Proprietary is non-standard and not open. That means others cannot poke into the proprietary stuff to make it better, and the consumers are stuck with the inferior, yet overpriced products. Microsoft Xbox is a textbook example of proprietary being bad. It uses USB joysticks with non-standard shaped connectors. It uses common DVDs with proprietary security sectors. It uses common flash memory cards with proprietary power specifications. It uses common hard drives with proprietary file systems and non-standard plugs. And it uses common USB drives, limiting them to 16 GB. Needless to say that the official Xbox hardware costs several times more than the average for the similar products. You can get a terabyte hard drive for the price of Microsoft 20 GB drive, and you can get 32 GB flash card for the price of Microsoft 16 MB memory card. The problem is Microsoft did not develop any hardware. They order standard and just change a few bytes in the firmware and alter the shape of the connectors so it won't fit to standard ports no more and resell them to the customers. Basically, it is the same equipment available on the market much cheaper. That is called extortion, and that is exactly the reason proprietary stuff exists, to glue the customers to the original supplier, depriving them of choice. There is a way to spoil the feast for the Microsoft, well, for a little bit at least. Some time ago, Microsoft allowed the users to store their data on USB drives. Of course, there is a catch. No matter how big the storage is, you may use only 16 GB of that. Want more? Purchase the original MSHDD for a skyrocket price. Actually, you may use the external drive to the full capacity with the Xbox 360. A quick disclaimer. No, the system will see only 16 GB, since increasing this value just crashes the system, but will trick the console to use the rest of the space. To do that, connect your external drive to the Xbox and follow the options menu items to prepare it for use with the console. Then connect the drive to your computer. What you'll see is a 16 GB partition with only one folder, Xbox 360. If you don't see the folder, enable Hidden Files View in the Control Panel folder options. The folder contains at least three data files. Together, they form the so-called FATX file system. Now copy this folder to your computer. Then, use a partitioning software to reformat the drive. There's like a ton of drive partitional tools. I wouldn't give instructions on using every single of them, but I would recommend starting with Gparted, which is free. What you need to do is delete all partitions from the external drive and create a single one for the whole space, and format it to FAT32. You have to do it in Partitioning Editor, since Windows is bad at managing partitions on removable drives, and it doesn't allow a FAT32 partition to exceed a couple of gigabytes. Partitioning editors have none of these limitations, so use it to create a single FAT32 volume for the whole capacity. Now copy the Xbox 360 folder to this drive, and create multiple copies of it, adding a digit to the end of the name. Basically, we are filling the entire drive capacity with 16 GB chunks. With the USB drive attached, the console will be using the folder named Xbox 360. So by renaming the Xbox 360 folder to some other name and removing the end number of some other Xbox 360 folder, you will force Xbox to use this folder. Yes, that is not very convenient and you have to use a computer for that, but this is the only way to use a standard drive with Xbox to its full capacity.